Morning students, today we'll start with this general characteristics of alkaline earth metals. Alkaline earth metals, generally it form the compounds which is predominantly ionic in nature. So whatever compounds it is formed from alkaline earth metals, most of the alkaline earth metals it is forming the compounds which is said to be ionic. But compared to alkali metals, it is less ionic. What is the reason behind this? Due to increased nuclear charge and smaller size. So these are the two factors. Because of these two factors only, it is less ionic than alkali metals. Now let us see oxides. Oxides, when we are saying alkaline earth metals, generally it is forming monoxides and peroxide. Except beryllium, other alkaline earth metals it is forming peroxides. Beryllium alone it won't form peroxide. Okay, beryllium oxide it is amphoteric in nature. Amphoteric means what? Both acidic as well as basic in nature. That is why beryllium oxide on dissolving it is giving beryllium hydroxide. See, this is what amphoteric. Beryllium hydroxide, it is reacting with base. At that time, it acts as an acid. So, acid plus base gives salt plus water. Same manner, beryllium hydroxide, it reacts with hydrochloric acid. In this situation, it is acting like base. Okay. In first equation, beryllium hydroxide acts as an acid. In second equation, it acts as a base. In both the cases, it is forming salt and water. Clear? Magnesium oxide, it is weakly basic. Okay. Generally, monoxides, it is obtained by heating the metals in oxygen. Beryllium plus oxygen gives beryllium oxide. Magnesium plus oxygen gives magnesium oxide. Likewise, only it will come. Here, this magnesium hydroxide, it is weakly basic. Whereas, calcium oxide, strontium oxide, barium oxide, these are strongly basic. Okay. Beryllium oxide, actually it is covalent in nature. Why? Due to the small size of beryllium ion. Okay, except beryllium, other alkaline earth metals form peroxide. Now only I said, for example, barium oxide. When it is heated with oxygen, it is giving barium peroxide. Same manner, hydroxides, how it is forming? By treating this alkaline oxide. So, alkaline earth metal oxide, once when it dissolves in water, it gives alkaline hydroxide. For example, calcium oxide in water, it is giving calcium hydroxide. Only thing is that thermal stability and basic character of hydroxide ion increases down the group. So, this kind of words, underline it. These two equations are important. How will you prove that? Beryllium hydroxide is amphoteric in nature. In such cases, you have to write both these equations. Okay. Now, let us see halides. Halides, how it is formed? By treating alkaline earth metal with halogen. Alkaline earth metal with halogen, it is forming halides. Okay. Beryllium halide, what is its nature? It is covalent in nature. Here we said no. Due to small size of beryllium ion, it is covalent in nature. Hygroscopic, even it fumes in moisture and it is soluble in organic solvents. Okay. Moreover, this beryllium chloride, it is having a chain-like structure in solid state. See, in page number 143, structure is given. So, just go through that while watching this video. Okay. So, beryllium chloride, it is having chain structure in solid state. Whereas it is forming a chloro-bridged dimer in vapor state. Clear? Even it is having the tendency to form halide hydrate. What is halide hydrate? For example, magnesium chloride with 8 molecules of water. Calcium chloride with 6 molecules of water. So that kind of hydrate formation, gradually it is decreasing. Clear? Now let us see the salts of oxoacids. In salts of oxoacids, first it is carbonates. whenever we are taking carbonate, for example, if I am taking calcium carbonate, on heating what happen? It is giving calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. The solubility of carbonate in water, it is decreasing down the group. Thermal stability increasing down the group. Why? With increasing cationic size. As the cationic size is increasing, thermal stability also increasing. Clear? Sulfates. When we are saying about sulfates, sulfate solubility decreases from calcium sulfate to beryllium sulfate. Clear? Here, solubility decreases from calcium sulfate to barium sulfate. By mistake, I said beryllium sulfate. It is barium sulfate. Clear? Next, nitrates. Nitrates generally it is obtained by dissolution. Dissolution is nothing but dissolving. Dissolving carbonates in dilute nitric acid. For example, magnesium nitrate crystallizes with 6 molecules of water. Whereas, see here, this barium nitrate. Barium nitrate, it is crystallizing as anhydrous salts. So, what does it mean? Gradually, hydrate formation is decreasing. What we are saying it here? Hydrate formation decreases. Tendency to form allied hydrates gradually decreases. I said no. Same thing it is justifying. Is this clear? Now, let us see the important compounds of calcium. In important compounds of calcium, first important compound is quicklime. Quicklime is nothing but calcium oxide. First, we'll see the preparation. How this quicklime is prepared? By the decomposition of calcium carbonate. So, once when we heat this calcium carbonate at the temperature of 1070 to 1270 Kelvin. That Kelvin also mentioned it. So, once when we are decomposing this calcium carbonate, it gives quicklime, which is nothing but calcium oxide. Okay. Properties, when we are saying this properties, calcium oxide, generally it is absorbing the moisture and carbon dioxide once when it is exposed to atmosphere. So, once when quicklime is kept open in atmosphere, at that time, this calcium oxide reacts with water and carbon dioxide which is present in the atmosphere. Okay. Calcium oxide, once when it is treated with water, it is giving calcium hydroxide. Calcium hydroxide is nothing but slaked lime which we are using for whitewashing. Even this calcium oxide, that is quicklime, reacts with carbon dioxide to form calcium carbonate. Okay. So, next, slaked lime. Slaked lime, now only we said, same thing. When we are adding limited amount of water, at that time, it breaks the lump of lime. This is what we are saying, it is slaking of lime. This preparation of slaked lime only, we are saying it is slaking of lime. Okay. Calcium oxide and sodium hydroxide mixture, together we are saying it is soda lime. The soda lime, we are using it for decarboxylation. So, decarboxylation is nothing but removal of carbon dioxide. Okay. That you will study in 12th standard. You should know it is a decarboxylating mixture. It is not given in your textbook, but make a note. Soda lime acts as a decarboxylating mixture. Calcium oxide and sodium hydroxide, together we are saying it as soda lime, which we are using it for decarboxylation. Clear? Next, with acidic oxides like silica, phosphorus pentoxide, it is giving calcium silicate. Same manner, calcium phosphate. Finally, we are going to see the uses of quicklime. What are the uses of quicklime? It is used to make cement, mortar, glass. Same manner, sodium carbonate. The slaked lime is nothing but calcium hydroxide. Even it is used in the purification of sugar. Also, it is used as a drying agent. Okay. So, with this, we'll complete today's class, students. In tomorrow's class, we'll continue the calcium hydroxide, gypsum and plaster of Paris. Thank you, students.